Hello students, welcome to online teaching by Takshila group. I already told you about digestive system in audio also. Now in this video I am going to explain you with the diagram. So digestive system in human beings, we have a holozoic mode of nutrition. Okay, so we digest and absorb food with our digestive system. Now digestive system is start with the mouth. So here is the mouth. So we know that in our mouth there is a teeth, tongue and some salivary glands, this parotid glands and salivary glands which secrete the saliva. Okay, so mouth is also known as a buccal cavity. Now in mouth there is a teeth which helps in chewing or grinding of a food, then tongue present which also helps in swallowing and moistening the food, and this salivary glands which help to secrete the saliva, which contain enzyme known as salivary amylase which digest the starch to carbohydrates. Okay, so digestion of food is start from the mouth only. So here you can see this is our respiratory tract or nasal chamber, and this is our mouth. So both are connected one here. So here there is a one pharynx which have a cartilaginous flap which differentiate the food pipe, which allow food only into a food pipe. Okay, so here is the pharynx also present. Now this is known as a esophagus. Esophagus means food pipe. Okay, now our food from mouth after digestion of starch, and it's known as a bolus. The saliva plus food is known as a bolus. Now bolus is transported to this stomach from through this esophagus. Now in stomach there is a digestive juices and HCl and inactive pepsinogen and mucus. So this stomach have the inner lining of stomach is mainly produce HCl. So this HCl is helping, there are many function of HCl, like it converts inactive pepsinogen into active pepsin, then it also kill harmful bacteria which coming through this food, and it also maintain the pH and acidic medium of the stomach. Then mucus, so mucus what mucus helps to prevent the damage of inner lining from the stomach. Okay, and that inactive pepsinogen is converted into active pepsin with the help of HCl. So this pepsin is helped in digestion of protein. Okay, so these are the functions of stomach. First is HCl, then mucus and pepsin. Then here you can see there is a pancreas, or here is the liver. So liver secretes some bile juices which is stored in this gallbladder. Here is the green color gallbladder. So secrete by liver and stored in the gallbladder. What? Bile juices. Okay. Now pancreas produces some pancreatic juices, that trypsin, pancreatic amylase, pancreatic lipase. So all this bile juice from gallbladder and pancreatic juice from pancreas is received by this small intestine. Okay, so and here from the stomach food is coming, then so this pancreatic juices and bile juices which mix with this food, so the digestion occurs, main digestion occurs in this small intestine. Okay, so this small intestine help in the digestion of some nutrients like carbohydrate, protein and amino acids. So small intestine in carbohydrates converted into glucose with the help of enzyme pancreatic amylase, then fats are converted or digested into fatty acid plus glycerol with the help of pancreatic lipase, and the trypsin convert the protein into a amino acids. Okay, so after digestion this small intestine has villi or finger like structure known as a villi, which increase the surface area, and it also help in the absorption of food to the bloodstream. Now whatever the undigested food is now comes to into this large intestine. Here it is 6.5 to 7 meter long, this small intestine, and the large intestine is 1.5 meter long. So whatever the undigested food is come to this large intestine, and here the water absorption of water and electrolytes occurs, and whatever the remaining undigested food, which is known as the stool or fecal matter, is stored in this rectum and excreted out through this anus. So this is the whole digestive system. Okay.